there's like actual like bone markings on it.
Come in here. Come check this one out. Hey, YouTube. Okay, so for today's adventure, I've got my son Cannon and I and our dog Drake. We're here outside of Camp Verde, Arizona. So I'm set up by the sign to show you a kind of a reference point. It says it's called the Beasley Flat Recreation Site, right? So I'm sure if you look that up, we're literally parked right here. And a friend of mine told me this location, and I'm probably going to pronounce it wrong, but it's called the Mindeleff Cavates. I'm sure I'm pronouncing that wrong. But these are these Native American, these caves that were excavated in the site along the Verde River that the Native Americans occupied. I don't really know a whole lot of the history about it, but we're in the area. We wanted to check it out. So to get here, like I said, we're just outside of Camp Verde, Arizona, and we're parked here at this recreation site. We're going to cross the Verde River. We're going to wade across the Verde River. I got my backpack with our hiking boots and shoes strapped to it. So right now he's got Crocs and I got flip-flops. We're gonna wade across this, and you can see him on the other side. There's just a whole bunch of like small caves. And I know that I've seen other videos that I expect that there's gonna be a lot of dust and bat guano in there. It's also a time of year when rattlesnakes are breeding, so we gotta watch out for snakes. It seems like that's a pretty likely thing to see, is rattlesnakes, dust. I was supposed to bring these dust masks and I forgot them, so we're gonna use some t-shirts to put over our face for the dust. Of course, we gotta be careful wading across the river, but it's pretty shallow, so we should be okay. And mostly I gotta keep my dog from getting bit by a rattlesnake. So, all right, we'll get going and we'll see you on the other side.
Old pirates, yes they rob I, sold I to the merchant ship. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit. But my hand was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation.
Okay, so we just finished crossing the river and changed into our boots and shoes. I got my hiking boots. Kaden's got some like trail running shoes. I crossed in my flip-flops, which is a little tricky. It's doable. It's not I wouldn't recommend it, but you could do it if you have to. Kaden had some Crocs. How did your Crocs work out?
Fine.
So what'd you say about crossing the river?
It's fine.
It's fine. Water's a little cold. The current's a little swift, but it was what, like ankle deep? Not too bad.
It's like knee deep.
You know, if you had some trekking poles, that might not be a bad idea. If you have trouble like walking in unstable situations. But anyway, so now we're on the other side against like kind of these cliffs. You see like a lot of little holes, little animal burrows and stuff. So we're gonna just go and explore and find the caves. Let's see. Okay. Which way do you think we should go? To the right or the left?
Yeah, the thing was on the right.
We're gonna try going to the right first. Come on, Drake. Drake. Here, Drake. And one thing about having a hunting dog is he's always on the move. Hey, Bubba, Drake. Drake. Come here. Drake, here. I like him to be able to explore, but a little bit worried about rattlesnakes today. Come on, Drake. Drake, here. Here. Okay. What do you think? We need to get up there, huh? Or do you want to keep going down this low spot for a while and find a way up there? It's not so steep. See where the big rocks are? Just scale up that. Here's the choices. We can either just scale straight up this, or we could kind of go straight. Come on, Drake.
We can make that.
I bet if we keep going to the right, though, looks like there might be a trail, sort of a trail. Oh, cool. Look at all those caves up there. I don't know if this is that native tobacco or that wild tobacco plant.
Oh, does it smell like tobacco?
I don't know. What does it smell like? Woo! No, I don't know. Well, there is sort of some sort of like Arizona. I don't know, some kind of Arizona tobacco plant. Yeah, I'm gonna climb up.
Over there.
Which way? This way?
Make sure you look it up here. Drake!
She's right here. Some people over there on their side by side heading out. We parked just right over there, so we're really only a couple hundred yards.
The Mindeleff Cavates is an archaeological site along the Verde River just outside of Camp Verde, Arizona. The word cavate was coined in the 19th century by explorer John Wesley Powell to distinguish between a type of more common cliff dwelling, which is a structure constructed inside of a natural cave or hollow, and this type of cavate, which is actually excavated in the natural stone. These cavates are named for the archaeologist Cosmos Mindeleff, who, with his wife, Marion, conducted a detailed archaeological expedition somewhere around 1891. Mindeleff's report was published in 1896 by the U.S. Bureau of Ethnology and was considered years ahead of its time in terms of the level of detail and accuracy for his approach to analyzing the land use and the settlement patterns of the native people in the area. It was at a time when many of the archaeologists were little more than artifact collectors with very little regard to preserving the actual sites or documenting the context.
I'll have to find an article
of their finds. The Mindeleff Cavates site consists of approximately 89 separate dwellings and a total of 343 rooms. These were each hand-carved out of a layer of soft sandstone sandwiched between two harder rock layers along the east banks of the Verde River, south of Camp Verde. At the peak of the civilization, it would have housed at least 250 people and possibly even more.
Yeah, they have like storage buildings.
A typical dwelling consists of a small opening in the cliff face, approximately 3 feet wide by 4 feet high, and this opening opens up into a round or oblong main room, approximately 15 feet across and tall enough to stand in. The main room will typically have one or more small alcoves for sleeping or storage, and when we visited the site, you could tell that the temperature was quite a bit cooler in some of these alcoves, you know, that you could possibly store food in or sleep in. The floors are generally flat. In some cases, they had been built up with rocks and mud plaster.
It's kind of awkward to crawl through this.
Archaeologists believe that this showed that there was evidence that masonry walls were once used to partition large rooms and protect some of the larger entrances.
I'm sure there's a combination.
Most of the walls have been destroyed by prehistoric and historic looters, like people and possible artifacts have long since disappeared.
Like here's a bird. Come over here. I'm sure swallows have come in here.
What? Oh, rad. See? It's like a whole valley of caves. So cool.
Reading from the website timhofflin.com, he has a blog post about the Mindeleff Cavates. As he describes, from about AD 1150 to AD 1350, these cavates were home to about 250 or more Sinuaga Indians.
If you would call it that.
It was known to be a gathering place, 15 degrees cooler than the outside temperature. It was a place that was close to the river, but it still offered a defensible position on the cliffside. A highly traveled place where people would come and engage in trade. Arrow shafts, quids, which are balls of agave, which were chewed like gum, maize, manos, rocks for grinding cone, and even small pieces of woven cotton cloth have been found in this area. Okay.
Yeah, I put on these running swimsuits, running shorts / swimsuit, but having some like real pants would be better. Even if you have to get your pants wet, I think it'd be better for the thorns and rocks and stuff. What? What do you got? Oh yeah. Oh, it's a. You know what it is? That's a beehive. Okay, I'm gonna go away from the beehive. Okay, bees. All right, see? You just gotta stay calm. Look at all these little holes. You still have a bee on you? Just.
It's in my shoelace.
Just give them calm energy.
Oh, dude, that crap. What's in there?
Like a coyote den or mountain lion den. Maybe we should not go in there. I'm not sure. Yeah, keep your eyes out for mountain lions too.
This is the most safe hike I've ever been on. Look how hard deep that goes.
It was a canyon wren I used for. Kind of like a, I don't know, like a silt stone or something.
Not that hard to chisel out.
Yeah. It's just kind of, it's like a silt stone. So it's really soft. Oh, wow. Oh, wow, it goes way in there.
Just let him go and then climb up there.
Sure.
Hey Drake, careful though.
Super cool. This is definitely mountain lion territory. Yeah, it's pretty wild. Lush grass.
It's natural grass?
I really don't know. It's probably not native grass. That's a good question. It's probably not native grass. With all the agriculture. Or is it a juniper? Hey, Drake. Drake, whoa. Come in here. Come check this one out. Okay, this one smells batty. Looks like a good bat cave to me. Or a good rattlesnake cave. Or a good rat cave. What else would live in here? Mountain lion, bobcat, ringtail. Looks like. Okay.
do it like a duck walk. You didn't actually have to crawl. I'm doing a duck walk. Duck walk. Alright. That's pretty cool. What? Temperature is pretty cool in there, in that one.
Yeah, how many people do you think
live? What?
How many people do you think live in this?
How many people?
If you visit the Mindeleff
Cavates, there was an entire civilization that lived in this valley.
Please be careful not to destroy or damage anything.
Probably a lot, yeah.
Look at that cliff. Look over there where it's like.
The site's not very well marked. We did see a sign on our way out.
Wait,
there's
squirrel?
Bats do use the cave, so try to avoid disturbing any bats. Also, it's good to know that when you are in a cave with bats, you know, there can be a lot of dust and there can be toxic dust.
Montezuma
Castle,
which is
I would suggest bringing a dust mask for when you are walking around in the caves.
Community.
It would be good to have some type of light as well.
Dwellings.
Be very mindful for there's a lot of different hazards, you know, including cactus, sharp rocks, falling off cliffs, rattlesnakes, animals.
I've only been there one time and it was like
1999. There could be mountain lions. There's all kinds of different things to look out for. So just be very mindful and be very careful.
I wonder if we could
please be careful
if we'd be
not to
allowed to go in there with
damage
Drake. It's like
anything or take any
it's like
artifacts.
It's just a small walking
It's an amazing site.
You have to stay on this path.
That we can enjoy.
But it's not very far.
It's
I wonder if they would let us take
open
it
and free to use. But let's try to protect it. It's a it's an amazing part of our southwestern heritage.
This looks kind of sketchy, that ledge. Like, I think we should go down and up the other side to get to there. We could go through this side. Did you come in that way?
I made it.
Oh. I just was thinking that ledge looks pretty pretty small.
Yeah, it's a little bit.
Sleeping areas?
Yeah, they have like storage buildings. That's pretty hard acting.
Well, our camera cut out before we could film the last part of the return back, crossing the river again, back to the car. So we're going to sign off here. Thanks for joining us on this adventure, and remember to get out there and explore the outdoors around you. You never know what you might find.
Weather. Here's a bird. I'm sure swallows have come in here.
Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever had, redemption songs, redemption songs.